ladies and gentlemen, Christy here from Happy and Healthy Wellness TV, coming to you live from my fantastic kitchen as always. So tonight I wanted to talk to you about for 100 days if a girl with Lyme documentary, day six. What's the topic for today? Topic for today is going to be really cool videos and or documentaries that I have found on Lyme disease, either on YouTube or on Netflix or, all different places. So obviously over the years, I've watched many documentaries and continue to do so on Lyme. The more I know, the better I can help myself and then one day go ahead and help others with that. So that's really important to me. So I'm going to start off with the most recent. The first video I've watched for Lyme, let me go back, was Under My Skin, which was available on YouTube and still is. It used to be free. Now you have to pay for it. Since then, Under My Skin 2 has come out. You know what? It's such a good documentary. It really catalogs and highlights all of the different things that we Lymeys go through. And it also looks at the stigma around Lyme disease and how patients are treated. And I have to tell you, really, as a patient with Lyme, as we've talked about before, it's pretty disgusting a lot of the times how we're treated by the medical community and how it's so misunderstood. And also, we'll get people that will constantly say, oh, well, you look fine or you look good. Well, gee, thanks. You know, I appreciate that. Takes a lot of work to look like this. Actually, not. I'm not wearing any makeup and my hair is a mess as usual. It's the end of the day. But Under My Skin has got a lot of great information. And if anything, it really advocates for those with Lyme. I really appreciate the way that they came off in that video, how they showed real patient stories. There was one young lady, I believe she was from Florida. My God, it just made me almost cry when I watched her on that documentary because you see she can barely walk. She's walking like completely bent over. And she's got to weigh like 70 pounds, this poor girl. And I've been there. I obviously don't look like that now. I've gained weight from one of the ridiculous medications that I'm on. But be that as it may, I was down to 70 pounds at 90 pounds for a really long time. I'm 5'6". I should not be 70 pounds. I should be at least 110 pounds as a nutritionist who knows weight well and 120 with muscle added on to that. So yeah, it was really crazy to see all of these people in that particular documentary. So Under My Skin 1 and 2, I definitely recommend to watch if you haven't checked anything else out. There's a video right now on YouTube. It's called Lyme Crime. And I thought that that was a really great, well-done video. There was another one that had popped up that Fox News had done that was on Lyme that was actually also pretty well done. Okay, we're not talking about politics, so I'm not going to bring up Fox News. But they did a really good job with this and really highlighted there are more and more people showing up with Lyme. What's going on? Why aren't people doing research? So they kind of had that angle on it. And I thought that was great. This is something, though, that I really thought was crazy. And this kind of freaked me out yesterday when I had saw it and a few days prior to. There is a documentary on Netflix. And I'm like a big Netflix fan. I don't like commercials and Netflix is great. I spend a lot of time, unfortunately, in bed when I'm not feeling well. So I do watch a lot of TV off of my laptop these days. So I should have canceled my cable because of that. Don't need it anymore. You know, let me save money on one bill. Whatever the case is, we don't need to know about me not paying a cable bill. The most important thing is I'm watching this documentary, Afflicted, and the first person I see on there has got mold sensitivity. And I started kind of looking, and people are thinking this poor young lady is absolutely insane. And some of the behaviors looked insane if you didn't know about Lyme disease. So I sat there, and I'm watching this girl, and she's talking about mold sensitivity. I'm like, my God, I've seen so many people with Lyme who have mold sensitivity. I am not horribly mold sensitive, I don't think anyway. I've never been tested for it myself. I have got heavy metal poisoning, I know that, but nothing else like really kind of sticking out, throwing out with mold. But I have absolutely talked to people that have had mold issues and believe that is a phenomenon with Lyme. It makes sense if you understand basic bio and you understand the mechanism of Lyme disease. So this poor young lady winds up moving all the way to the desert because she can no longer tolerate being in her apartment due to mold. And she has a hard time going outside anywhere due to mold. So sad. So this girl's living out in the middle of the desert with her boyfriend. God bless this guy. He's taking care of her, whatever the case is. the story goes on to all of a sudden Dr. Horowitz pops up on the screen, and I'm just like, hold on a minute. If I thought that maybe this was like a little bit of a strange documentary at first, now I'm paying attention because Dr. Horowitz is there and I respect his opinion. So he starts talking about mold sensitivity, and I'm like, something is going to happen with this girl with Lyme. Sure enough, she finds out from a naturopath she's got Lyme, and later winds up at a clinic in LA being treated for Lyme disease. So she's got Lyme. Sorry, I don't mean to reveal the whole documentary. There are several other people on there that also have Lyme. There's a gentleman on there with Lyme who's in what I call the wasting phase of Lyme. This poor gentleman gets so skinny again. Lyme's tend to lose a lot of weight. I'm not an indicator of that right now, again, because I'm on a medication to help me sleep because I have alpha intrusion and Lyme has attacked my brain, so I don't sleep very well anymore despite trying every supplement in the book, including really not fun peptide injections in my stomach. That was exciting having to do that. I didn't want to become a nurse or a doctor because it wasn't my thing, but also because I didn't want to poke people with needles. I've had many of them, can't do it to myself. Sidebar about me, whatever the case. So there's a gentleman on there who's in that wasting phase, can barely tolerate or eat any food. I'm like, okay, I feel like I'm watching myself. Can barely leave his room, can't leave the house, is constantly sick, you know, and has been shunned by most doctors. And of course, like I think a lot of Lymies, we have to become our own advocates. And I would like to say, based on what I saw in this video last night, we're kind of abandoned, I hate to say this, not by everybody in the medical community, but by the majority of it right now in this present time and future in life. I'm hoping in the future that stigma changes, and with things like these documentaries coming out, you know, will help promote more awareness. I think just about every day I look on YouTube or I surf around, I find another new documentary that's excellent. So there are tons and tons and tons of good documentaries out there. One other person that was in this particular documentary, Afflicted, on Netflix, God, it was so sad. This poor woman spent literally like $2 million on treatment. $2 million to figure out what was wrong with her. She had dystonia. She had a whole bunch of other health conditions. And again, I'm looking at this woman and I'm like, she's got freaking Lyme disease. Like, I'm like sure of it. Just as like, I can size up a case like this. You know, I joke around. I've been practicing since 2007. So for 11 years now, and I've gotten to practice with some amazing practitioners, very highly respected doctors, people who have written award-winning books. You know, I've been able to achieve that, so I guess I'm part of that crowd, although I look at, you know, I still respect my peers and people that I have gone to school with, or not just gone to school with, but people who have trained me. So I've been very fortunate in that, and also having the fortunate opportunity to have worked with a wonderful company for many years, where I was able to mentor underneath one of the top functional neurologists in the whole world. So like, how many people get that lucky? Yeah, I got that job and I was later screaming in the parking lot after that happened because I was so excited. So that was a cool thing. But what I'm leading up to is that my training with functional neuro that's married to nutrition, and then also understanding immunology, and then really just understanding Lyme, not only from a personal perspective, but from a practitioner perspective. So I have a little bit of both, which is nice. Thank God for that. It's kept me alive. You know, I was diagnosed terminal December, I'll never forget the date. It was December 17th of 2015. I was told I had until April of 16. You guys, we're now almost in September of 2018, and I'm still sitting here talking to you. And you know, I have my bad days, as you guys know, but I am fortunate enough to have more good than bad, despite the fact that I keep getting some funky diagnoses with my Lyme. But it's all right. We deal with them and we keep going. So my point to this was, this young lady spent this like $2 million on treatment. She's like, has all these interesting health calamities that have mirrored stuff that I've seen with myself with Lyme, with other patients with Lyme, with just general people I've spoken to about Lyme disease, and crazy town. So who does she wind up going to see? Dr. Klinghart. You gotta be kidding me. So my current Lyme doctor actually studied under Dr. Klinghart for like 10 years. So I highly respect Dr. Klinghart. As I've said, Dr. Dietrich Klinghart. Yeah, see, this is what Lyme has done to me. Blah, there goes my speech. Maybe I just speak too quickly. That might be part of the problem. Anyway, so Dr. Klinghart starts to treat this young lady that goes in who spent $2 million on all these other crazy treatments that didn't work for her. And so she finds out she also has Lyme disease. Are you serious? Like, I saw this and I'm sitting there the whole time like, this one has Lyme, that one has Lyme, this one. Now, there's a thing that doctors say. When I hear hoofbeats, I think horses, not zebras, right? All right. So one could argue with me and say, oh, Christy, well, you have Lyme, so you're just seeing it everywhere. Am I just seeing it everywhere because I know a lot about it and I can tell, like, maybe somebody has multiple sclerosis. My first thought is you maybe have Lyme disease. Or somebody comes to me with fibromyalgia. I wonder if that's Lyme. Somebody comes to me with chemical sensitivity, mold toxicity issues. I definitely, to me, horses, hoofbeats, instead of horses, I hear like Lyme disease screaming in my head. Now, again, you can have other causes to multiple sclerosis or fibro or any of these conditions I've just mentioned. Sarcoidosis, which is something I was diagnosed with, doesn't just come from Lyme. It can come from other things. Your immune system is going to play a big role in this. How did you get Lyme? Where did it come from? Why do some people have exposure to Lyme and then are able to fight it off? Someone had asked me that earlier. Well, this is a good reason. Immunity has a lot to do with it. There are pieces of functional neuro that I believe have a lot to do with it. Somebody who is right hemispheric weak versus left, we see a weaker right hemisphere, I'm going to see a more overactive immune system. And that can cause the body to start attacking itself. Likewise, going the other way around. If I have somebody who is left brain weak, because the left side of the brain is like the control tower and it helps control the immune system, that person's going to have a lowered ability to fight infection. So now you're even more susceptible to winding up with something like Lyme. Especially if you have not had it treated in its first stages, I cannot stress that enough. If you find a tick on you, you so need to get treated. And make sure that you do it early on. My mistake, as you guys all know, was I got bit by two ticks back in 07. I brought the tick with me to the doctor. I did everything that I knew as a practitioner to do. That tick got thrown out. Man, if I knew then what I know now, very good book by Doreen Guma, which I was very lucky to get to write a chapter in. I will use that phrase. If I knew then what I know now, holy crap. Yeah, my life would be a lot different, but I always look at Lyme as if it was my teacher, and it still is. I've learned a lot from having Lyme disease. So, I thought treating Crohn's disease was easy, and it for me is. And IBD, IBS is a very simple disease for me to treat. I've been working with it for a long time, have achieved remission from it for a very long time. But Lyme, like we say, comes in all different flavors, shapes, and sizes, like an ice cream cone, as I always say. So a little bit more difficult to treat Lyme as it gets older and it's in later stages and we have different co-infections. So anyway, this young lady, a lot of these people got better on the show, which is my cool thing about it. And this is a true documentary. So I think that would be equally as important to watch. So yes, I will highlight new documentaries as I watch new ones. Those are just a few off the top of my head that you can check out. And again, most of the things you can find on YouTube. Again, you don't know if everything on YouTube is credible, so I'd be careful with that. If Netflix is putting something out, again, I would think that would be a little bit more credible. No offense to anybody that's published stuff on YouTube. I obviously publish stuff on YouTube every day, you know, and I know that my education and my experience lend me to be credible. And if I don't know the answer to something, I always say I will make sure I ask the smartest person in the room or the smartest person I can find until I find someone that knows the answer. And I think that's really important, especially when you're on a quest to deal with something like Lyme. It's very well possible you have a lot of people ignore what's really going on and or blame it on a psych issue. And the question always is, did the chicken come before the egg? Was the psych issue there first or was the Lyme issue there first? The Afflicted documentary I found pretty interesting because there was one of the young ladies on there did have some significant mental health issues. And again, did this girl have Lyme disease for years or did she have mental health problems and then wind up with Lyme later? Now, if that was the case, maybe mental health issue playing a role, my thought process then would be to say, okay, if you have mental health problems, you're thinking on a negative basis, that's going to lower immunity, which is a concern. And if you're under a lot of stress, that's going to change your hormones around, raise cortisol levels and things like that, which can lead to problems with digestion, We always say death starts in the colon. That's my saying from my first book, the IBD Healing Plan and Recipe book. And that, there's nothing truer than that. If you can't digest and or break down food, you're in big trouble. Because how do we get nutrition and how does the body then repair and restore itself and make ATP? That's really, really important. If the body's not making ATP, it's not finishing out the Krebs cycle. So that's an issue. All right, guys, so that's enough for me today. Those are just some documentaries out there. So again, Under Our Skin or Under My Skin, one or the other, if you check that out on YouTube, that's floating around. I think it's like $2.99 if you want to rent that. And there are versions 1 and 2 of that. We talked about Lyme Prime, a very interesting YouTube link that I'll post on the bottom for a Fox News video that was on Lyme. I thought that was interesting. And then this Netflix documentary called Afflicted. So I would definitely go ahead and check that out. And like I said, Dr. Horowitz and Dr. Klinghardt are both on that Afflicted documentary. So I, as soon as I saw Horowitz, I'm like, yeah, these people definitely have Lyme. Why else would he be speaking about this? But let's remember, too, that Dr. Horowitz works with people with chronic illness, and so does Dr. Klinghardt. So, you know, I wasn't 100% sure when I saw that, but it was kind of pretty much in the bag when I saw the two of them on there. So, really great documentary, guys. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comment box below. If you'd like to see more videos on Lyme disease or more general health videos or me just dancing around playing my flute because it's just fun and I like to do that, you can subscribe to our channel by hitting the subscribe button. And please go ahead and do that. We try to make at least a few videos a week and they're on varying health topics. I just did one on vitamin B1 for happy and healthy for the practice. And this one obviously is for anybody with Lyme disease or who thinks that they have Lyme. So that's who this is targeted for. And my vitamin N/music videos are just for me to dance around and have fun and show that besides nutrition, I do other cool stuff. All right, guys. So other ways to get in touch with us, you can reach me at Christy@happyandhealthywellness.com by email. Or you can shoot me a phone call. Give me a shout at 631-835-5003. I do work with patients all across the country. You do not have to be in New York to work with me. I've been very fortunate to know people all across the world, actually, and be able to work with patients from Europe all the way back to California, back, you know, all over the place. So I thank you guys for watching this today, and I hope this was helpful to you. And I hope wherever you're coming from tonight that you're feeling well or you're on your way there. I'm very blessed. I had a very good day today. I've been up since 4:30 in the morning. I came from a sleep study this morning and then came home, got a lot of stuff done, and you know, did my thing for today. So it was a really great day in good old sunny New York. So we've got 1.5 weeks left of summer, and I'm sad. This is my beach season, and I'm always low on vitamin D, so I like to be out in the sun as much as I possibly can. So I will be working on my Lyme book tomorrow, which will be called The Lyme Disease Healing Plan. We're hoping that will be out by mid-2019. So I'm really excited about that. Guys, I've been working my tail off on that. And it's taking me a very long time to write because my cognition is a little slower than it was before when I used to type 9,000 miles an hour and words would just spit off my brain and tongue like I wasn't even thinking. So I know most of my fellow Lymies who've had neural Lyme can understand that old brain fog thing. If I, sidebar, like if I read something that I wrote like 3 or 4 years ago, my God, what a difference in the quality of my writing. So as somebody who's been writing since they were 5, I'm not kidding you, I was like 5 when I wrote my first book that got offered to be published by a self-publishing company way, way, way back then. I was very fortunate for that. So again, guys, that's going to be all for me tonight. We're going to wrap this video up. I hope everybody has a good day or a good night, whatever time you're coming to me from. And I hope everybody takes care and love you guys. Mwah. Have a good night or day. Take care.